Hello everyone, this is important news. Qwen-Image's ControlNet has been officially released. This is highly significant because it wasn't released by other community users, but by the official Qwen-Image team. Based on actual testing, we've found that the Inpaint model offers the best results. For example, you can transform an item in a beautiful woman's hand into a very cute kitten. Or, you can change a high-stemmed glass in her hand into a bouquet of flowers. These are relatively simple applications. Additionally, Inpaint offers special functionalities like watermark removal. Look at this example. I have an image of a beautiful woman with a large watermark at the bottom. Previously, removing such watermarks required a dedicated watermark removal model or object removal model. But now, with Qwen-Image's Inpaint, it's incredibly straightforward to remove. We'll discuss the how-to later. Beyond Inpaint, there are two other crucial ControlNet models. One is Canny, which generates target images based on contour maps. You can see the tested results. The second is Depth. Many of you are likely familiar with this, as it's generally believed that Depth's performance is superior to Canny's. However, please note that both Canny and Depth generation techniques have a certain drawback. Have you noticed that images generated by ChatGPT often have an inexplicable yellow tint? These images, generated by Canny and Depth, also exhibit this. Their screens all appear yellowish. This is considered a significant drawback. We'll elaborate on the specifics when we get to the workflow. Currently, Qwen-Image's ControlNet models are officially supported by ComfyUI. You can find this repository information in ComfyUI's official Hugging Face repository. Within this ControlNet, there are two forms. The first is in LoRA form. The second is in Model Patch form. Today, we'll primarily focus on the second type, the Model Patch, because many of you are already familiar with LoRA. In my opinion, LoRA's implementation of ControlNet generally doesn't yield as good results. Take a look. These three models, Canny, Depth, and Inpaint, are all the same size, 2.27 GB each. To use these models, it's simple. Just update your ComfyUI to the latest version. Let's begin with Depth, as its overall application is arguably the widest. From user habits, OpenPose or DupinPose, and Depth are the two most preferred models. However, the OpenPose ControlNet is not yet available, so we'll start with Depth. The basic architecture of this workflow is quite similar to Qwen-Image's text-to-image workflow. Let's quickly review it. First, the configuration part, where we set the width and height. Next, the model loading part. This includes the main Qwen text-to-image model, followed by Qwen's self-developed encoder and its V. I've also loaded an acceleration model, which many of you are familiar with. Qwen-Image's 8-step sampling acceleration model. We then save them separately, forming the standard 3 model components. Now, let's look at the image processing part. This is quite simple. We have a reference image. I will use an auxiliary preprocessor, such as Depth Anything V2, to extract the required ControlNet image, specifically the depth map. Note that the default resolution here is 512, so after extraction, we need to resize it. The resizing standard is based on our configuration settings. After that, we will get the scale depth image. Next, let's examine the most crucial part, how this ControlNet is implemented. First, you need to notice a very important node here called QWEE, Qwen-Image DiffSynth ControlNet. This is a new node that appeared in the officially released beta version. Its role is to load the ControlNet released by DiffSynth into our main model. Why do I say this? Because the model we are loading here is a patch model. The node is called Model Patch Loader. The patch we are loading is the depth model we just downloaded. We will then apply this patch to the main model. So, this node will be used. The main inputs to this node are our main model, our patch model, the VAE, and our reference image. If you were doing Inpaint, there would be a mask. Since I am just performing simple control, I have not connected the mask. Once all connections are made, we will generate another model. I call this the control model, meaning our main model has now loaded the ControlNet model and has become a main model with control capabilities. For demonstration purposes, I took a shortcut. I used Running Hub's prompt generation node tagging tool to generate the prompt. The basis for this prompt generation is our original image. The advantage of doing this is that I don't need to write prompts myself. After extensive testing, I can confidently say that Running Hub's tagging tool or prompt generation node works exceptionally well. If you don't believe me, give it a try. Additionally, To make the generated image more similar to the original, I added a prefix prompt here, a beautiful Korean girl. I then concatenate this with the generated prompt and feed it into the text encoder. The other inputs are quite simple. Please note that the latent image here is still empty. Just ensure its resolution is the same as our set configuration. Finally, for the sampling part, since I use the acceleration model, the steps are 8 and CFG is 1. My sampler is Euler and the scheduler is Beta. Let's look at the final generated result. As you can see, the effect is fantastic. Comparing it with the original image, you'll find that the overall consistency is very strong. Also, please note that there's a very important option in this node called strength. This is similar to the weight parameter in regular ControlNet. You can set it according to your needs. I didn't adjust it here, just used the default value of 1. Now, let's address the issue we discussed earlier, the generated images having a yellowish tint. I don't need to point it out. You can probably see the inexplicable yellow hue in it, as if a nostalgic filter has been applied. How do we handle this? Different people might have different approaches. If you are an experienced designer, you can use photo editing software to adjust its histogram or many other parameters. However, if you're not very familiar with that, you can use a color correction node for a rough or preliminary solution. This method is quite simple and direct. Let me demonstrate. You can use color match. We need to use the reference image as a benchmark to correct the generated image. Let's run it again. Look at the result we get. It's fantastic. Very clear and transparent, isn't it? However, you must note that this is not a universal processing technique. It is only a general processing method when replicating an image. Let's do a simple demonstration. Suppose I write a prompt now, like a beautiful woman dark night scene, meaning a beautiful woman in a night scene. If we run it like this, you'll see that this correction method fails. This is because the color distribution of your newly generated image is not quite the same as your reference image. But clearly, this image is also yellowish. So, this is only one of the correction techniques. Please do not assume it can be widely applied to every scenario. Next, let's look at the second workflow. The second workflow is the same as the first one. The only difference is this part has been changed. We've switched to Canny. Similarly, our preprocessor has also been changed to Canny Edge, which extracts the contour map. Then, we use the same patch node to apply our patch to our main model. Nothing else has changed. Let's look at the effect. This is our reference image, a very beautiful woman. Now, let's start generating the effect. Hey, this is also fantastic. I won't do other tests. The basic usage is this. The generated image quality is not an issue. The only problem, as you've seen, is the yellow tint. Next, let's look at the third workflow. The third workflow is slightly more complex because it involves Inpaint, and it's a workflow where users often make mistakes during construction. First, you need to understand that for the reference image, there's no need to extract contour or depth maps. What you need to do is use a mask editor or a segment node to select the part you want to repaint and generate a mask. In my case, I used the mask editor. Look, I've marked the high-stemmed glass in her hand. This mask can be slightly larger. It's not a problem. Let me draw and save this part. Furthermore, note that I haven't configured the width and height here. This is because the image we are generating is a local redrawing of the original image, so its width and height remain consistent with our reference image. This is the first point to note. The second point, as you can see, is that, as a patch model, we need to use the InPaint model. Additionally, you need to pay attention to where the mask needs to be connected. Now, a common point of error for users is here. Look closely. You still need to generate an empty, latent space image and feed it to the latent input. This is not what we would conventionally expect, which is to VAE, encode the original image, and then feed it here. Furthermore, the prompt must be clearly written to define the scene you want to create. For instance, we are currently writing about this beautiful woman holding a bouquet of flowers. So, let's look at the final generated effect. It's very beautiful, isn't it? Let's try another example. For instance, this one. Similarly, I'll draw a mask at the position of her hand. This mask can be a bit larger, no problem. Let's draw it here and save it. After that, we need to make some adjustments to the prompt. For example, I'll still write a beautiful woman holding a cute kitten. Now, let's run it. Take a look at this effect. Isn't it amazing? Let's zoom in a bit. The overall form of the kitten and its fit with the character's hand far exceed other models. InPaint also has another very important use. Let's look at this example. I've uploaded an image of a beautiful woman sitting on a red sofa. The biggest flaw in this image is a large watermark. If I want to remove this watermark now, how should I do it? Previously, doing this, while not overly complicated, wasn't particularly simple either, right? So, let's see how simple it is with this model. How do we do it? We open the mask editor, then paint over the watermark and save it. You might ask, what about the prompt? The prompt doesn't need to be written. Leave it blank. Then, we run it. Look, the watermark has been removed. So, this is also a special usage of the Inpaint model. I hope this is helpful to everyone. These are the three Qwe Qwen-Image ControlNet models we introduced today. One is contour-based canny, one is depth-based depth, and one is for local redrawing. Inpaint, overall, the performance of these ControlNet models is very impressive. However, depth and canny both exhibit a slight color cast, meaning they appear yellowish. As for Inpaint, we believe its performance is outstanding, whether for internal redrawing or our special technique for watermark removal. So, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and try it yourself. Follow me to become someone who understands AI.